What's SFC?
What's
yeah, it's not like a common thing in Catholic culture.
Right? It's like Buddy Tinder for Christ.
Just finished editing another vlog. That was actually the last vlog you guys just saw. And right now I'm gonna hit a gym session with my coach Kevin. You guys already know him. It's funny, the more times he's in my videos, the more interactions I get. So, and plus, who better also explain informational vlogs than my coach? I don't know what today's topic is just yet, but all I know is it'll always be a good one with him talking anyway. So as you guys know, prep has actually started. Yes, that is an Ariana Grande poster right there. For those people asking that seen it on my previous vlogs, yes, I do have her on my wall. Anyways, I've started prep and look what we have for Mother's Day tomorrow. Caramel cake. Yes, my pre-workout is cereal. It's supposed to be my post-workout, but as you guys can see, it's 9 p.m.
right there.
And I thought I might as well just use my carbs pre-workout instead of post, because by the time I finish my workout, I'll be heading home, whey shake, maybe a can of tuna, and go straight to sleep. It's been a long day.
It's like Buddy Tinder for Christ.
I know, it's quite stupid.
Why is it that the name is?
Anyways, I'll see you guys at the gym.
Yeah, parking skills.
That was my coach, by the way. I need to take him in.
Oh man, how's it going?
Oh shit.
It's like a noodle, bro.
Yeah, yours is just a noodle.
Egg noodle.
Egg noodle's still pretty small, bro.
Bro, at least mine didn't leave the country to fucking get away from my cock.
Well, nah.
What's up guys, so another informational vlog going on. Hope you guys enjoyed that little workout edit. With this informational vlog we've got, as you guys know, I like to make videos of what I do in a day, but at the same time at least one segment that brings valuable content to my videos, because I don't want to be just that typical guy that puts what I eat, wake up in the morning, do what I do in my day. I want to bring value to my videos, so hopefully by bringing value you guys will get something out of it. And as you guys already know, the person that brings value to my videos so far is Kevin, my coach. And I think it's only appropriate to talk about the topic L-carnitine, the supplement, or fat burners in general. You know, with all these athletes posting, you know, prep's coming, I'm gonna eat my broccoli and chicken, I think they start to advertise L-carnitine. And, you know, so it got me thinking one time, why don't I talk about L-carnitine more? Also, if you guys, loyal fans out there that actually watch my videos, last year I had a little 1 minute talk about L-carnitine. I watched it last night. Holy shit, was it shit. I sat there mumbling. This year, with a bit of a change, I'll get Kevin to talk about it.
Acetyl-L-carnitine, or carnitine in general, helps to mobilize fat or transport fatty acids into your mitochondria to be used for energy.
Let me stop you there. Mitochondria, by the way, is just a organelle in your cell. In case you guys, it's pretty much just an organelle in your cell.
It's your energy powerhouse
of the cell, yeah. And muscle cells, things like that.
Right. Acetyl-L-carnitine, or carnitine in general, will help transport fatty acids to the mitochondria to use energy. However, the bioavailability of carnitine taken orally is pretty poos. put it bluntly. So if you were, and I don't know the exact numbers, but if you were to take, say, 5 grams of carnitine, acetyl carnitine, pre-cardio, the actual effect of that into the mitochondria is
pretty poops.
Maybe 1 gram, which is nothing in the grand scheme of things.
Let's actually make it easier, because L-carnitine I took last year that I've talked about was 15 ml. So let's talk about ml form. Are you talking about L-carnitine powder form? Or?
Yeah. So the other thing to bear in mind is that the best form of carnitine, which is acetyl L-carnitine, because it has a vast array of benefits, is not stable in liquid format.
15 mils is 15 grams.
There you go. So, got 15 grams of carnitine, which is probably enough to give you the shits as well.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if I talked about that last year. I'm pretty sure I didn't. That L-carnitine, yes, it gave me shits. Like, I'm talking about 15. So, I was told to take, not by my coach now, but I was told before last year to take L-carnitine before my cardio. My cardio was 1 hour long. At some points of the week, I had to stop mid-hour to run to the toilet and have a quick shit. Because if I kept going, shit's gonna run down the stairmaster. It was that bad. Like, it gave me mad shits. And yeah,
so that shows how ineffective 15 mil of carnitine is.
It was useless.
Waste of time, except for giving you the shits. The other thing to bear in mind, or to be aware of, is that carnitine is not an acute product. So, or an acute medication, so it doesn't work straight away. If you're told to take carnitine pre-cardio because it's going to help with mobilizing fat, it will if you've already got a buildup of carnitine in your mitochondria or in the body. If you don't, then it's pointless. And again, the bioavailability of carnitine in your system, if you were taking 15 mil when you're only getting 1 mil, or 15 grams getting 1 gram, or you're shitting out
the rest of it,
then it's a waste of time. The real benefit, and the unfortunate thing for a lot of people, is that it's not logical. The real application, the easiest way for the average Joe Blogs or Mary Muffin Top to take carnitine is with your post-workout meal, when you spike your insulin.
Oh.
Because insulin is gonna help transport that carnitine where it needs to go. So you're increasing the bioavailability by helping it being transported with an insulin spike. The other way to do that, and this is not what we recommend, is to inject that into the muscle. And it's a long time. You don't just take a pill and then in 5 minutes it's working. At least it's things like caffeine or something like that. The cool thing about acetyl carnitine, if you're going to supplement that longer term, is it's the only form of carnitine that can pass through the blood-brain barrier. And it's an amazing product for quality of life. So take away the fat transporting benefits, amazing product for quality of life. So if you are getting old like myself and you are getting forgetful, it's actually a great medication. Studies have shown that it helps Alzheimer's patients in terms of with memory. So it's amazing because it helps with cognitive benefits. So some people may have it pre-workout to help with cognitive benefit. Bear in mind though, again, it's not an acute product.
Just to make it, again, just like the other videos we have, we try to make things as black and white as possible for the general public to actually try to understand. So yes, it does have benefits, like you said in the video. Is it necessary for the average Joe Blogger, Mary Muffin Top?
No,
we don't think so. Unless you're planning to inject it with an insulin spike.
Look, if you have disposable income, or you want to get the 1% out of everything, and you take it, then no drama. Just bear in mind that it's not a magic pill or a magic powder. And someone says to you, take L-carnitine before you go for cardio.
It helps with transporting fat.
Yes, it helps transporting fat, but it's not a cute product. It's not going to work within 5 to 10 minutes of taking it. You want to take it post-workout, in my view, with an insulin spike, so your post-workout carbs, to get that better bioavailability, the uptake into the muscle, the mitochondria. The flip side of that, if you've got an inefficient mitochondria, you're fucked anyway. So, you'll learn that nothing works in isolation. So when we talk about stuff, we're not talking about things in isolation, but we've only got a limited time to talk. So the key is to go back and revisit the previous videos and start stringing all of the shit together. Or ask Martin in a DM or whatever, what other things you want us to talk about that you think we may have missed or that don't exactly make sense in the previous vlogs.
And I know I talked a lot of shit on Instagram,
a lot.
I openly recommend or invite you guys to challenge the things we say, because I think it's only fair for you guys to question us as well. Like I say all the time, which I've learned from my coach, question everything. And if you guys, for some reason, have any suspicions or questions that you want to ask us with regards to the information we're taking out, by all means, flick us a message and we'll get right back to you guys as soon as we can. And you know, this is the only way we'll learn, if we keep discussing and asking questions.
It sounds like we're a bit anti everything, but we're not. So we're not anti acetyl accounting. It has its benefits, but it's just making you aware that it's not. When people say, do you take it pre-cardio? Doesn't work like that. So yes, take it. It's not a necessary product, because your body produces itself. It gets it from the food that you eat. If you're on prep, for example, and your food, your micronutrients are a bit limited, then possibly a good idea to have it. But then I would have it with my post-workout meal or my first carb meal, and get that insulin spike to help that transportation.
So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys actually took something from that. This video, in my opinion, is quite a valuable one, especially if you guys are going through prep, because I know a lot of you guys are competing with me on stage, those of you guys who are watching this, or at least the other competitions coming up. And I hope you guys stay tuned for more videos, flick us messages, and thank you guys for watching. We'll catch you guys in the next one.